Jonathan, how did you feel about doing the second storm?
It was a massive opportunity for me. I did love the spectacle of the first film, and it was a great cast to sort of be able to direct. So that was an awesome opportunity.
I was going to say, you've got some fantastic actors who are new to this one as well. Rosamund Pike, Toby Kebbell. How was it directing all of these huge names?
It was great. I mean, I don't like to think of it as directing them as much as asking these guys questions, because they all have such great ideas, and then just executing the ideas which are my sort of favorites, and then claiming them as my own.
So did they have input? They sort of...
Yeah, no, everyone had a lot of input. I mean, I like that. I like the idea of, especially when you're dealing with, say, guys like Ralph Fiennes and Liam Neeson and Sam Worthington, you want to give these guys input because they've done such great work before.
Mm-hmm. Were you ever sort of nervous asking them to do anything? Or?
No, not really. I mean, they were game for anything. It's something about coming on the set of a movie like this makes everyone just want to do their own stunts. I had to convince people not to do certain things because we needed them the next day and I didn't want them to hurt themselves.
Yeah, I read that Sam is very keen to sort of run around and do all the
stuff. He loves it. He loves all that, beating himself up. It's his favorite pastime.
The 3D is fantastic. It sort of made me, I had to close my eyes for some of it. Has it changed from the first film? Did you change the way that you filmed it?
Yeah, I mean, what it was the first movie, they literally did it in 6 weeks right at the end. We knew this movie was going to be 3D from the start, so we spent a whole year planning the 3D, planning the movie for 3D, working on it. So it was a completely different process on this movie from the first.
It really shows. It's brilliant.
Thank you.
How did you go about sort of creating the monsters?
The main brief that I wanted to do was make sure that these are the most photorealistic creatures that we had seen. So literally it would be from the animation we referenced, I guess, real animals, real things, and the textures you pick are ones which computers can render as realistic as possible. Mm-hmm. So that's how we went about it.
They're pretty terrifying. Which one is your favorite one?
The favorite one, I think at the end of the day, I started off loving the Cyclops, but my favorite at the end of the day is the Chimera. I thought that was a pretty cool sequence.
Yeah. What is it you think that's so fascinating about Greek mythology that draws audiences in?
I think that the characters, you know, it's all about family dysfunction and stuff like that, and the things which are still relevant today, where you have love, betrayal, lust, all that stuff is still relevant today. So I think Greek mythology is those stories in its purest form.
Yeah. How did you, the scenery in the film is fantastic, how did you decide where to, did you sort of have to do recces or?
Yeah, there were a lot of recces, but a lot of that work had been done from the first movie, going to those same locations, you know, Tenerife, Wales, England, stuff like that. We had the guys had already shot there before, so it was a matter of just going back to the same locations.
There's a rumour that you are going to be working on the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Is that true?
It's true, yeah.
Amazing. Are they actually still going to be teenagers, or are you going to
change?
They
are Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, yeah.
Fantastic. And when do you start work on that?
We already have sort of started.
Wow. Is that, have you cast it? And
no, we haven't cast it. We're just busy on the script now.